All right, so tattoos have become more relevant towards today's society, whether it be through modern art forms or personal significance. Tattoos today can also be seen as controversial when related to the workplace and or the look of the art. Tattooing is a more common form of expression through art on the body. Although they have been more openly accepted as of recently, tattoos have been around for quite some time. Through this presentation, you, my audience, will learn the history of tattoos and how they are accepted. By knowing the history of tattoos, you may be more open to the form of self-expression, as well as understanding the cultural significance of it. As I have some ink myself, I have quite a large fascination with tattoos. So today we are going to get a tattoo ourselves, that tattoo being the knowledge of how this art form came to be. First, we have to start with the basis of any tattoo, that being the tattoo gun and how it was invented. So next we will start with the needle of the gun, that being the history of tattoos, and then lastly we will focus on the tattooing process, representing the way tattoos are accepted into society. So let's get buzzing and start with the history of the tattoo gun. So the tattoo gun was invented by Samuel F. O'Reilly in New York City, and the tattoo gun was first patented on December 8, 1891. As you can see here, this is what in the far left-hand side, you can see what the tattoo gun looks like today. And then this is what his design looked like after he based it off of one, which I will talk about. The tattoo gun was originally based off of Thomas Edison's rotary operated stencil pen. You can see it in the lower left-hand side. O'Reilly's tattoo gun revolutionized the trade of tattooing and then also made tattoos more appealing to the modern ages. The tattoo gun was essentially a modified hammer, which you can see right here. Back then, a hammer was a handheld tool used to drill into cavities, so it's like what we have in the dentist's office today. O'Reilly modified the hammer by adding an ink reservoir and accommodations for more than one needle. Like the needle found in the tattoo gun, there is another point, that being the history of tattoos. Alright, so tattoos were first discovered to be a thing in the Egyptian era. The first tattoo from this era was first discovered in 1991 when scientists found and excavated a mummy that they later named Otzi. Scientists later acknowledged that the tattoos found on Otzi represented the gods of their time. And this is the only picture that I could find of one of his tattoos. Now, unlike the Egyptians, ancient Romans did not adopt the tattoo. The Romans believed that the purity of the human form, so they generally banned tattoos. The only way that they used them was for branding criminals and then just marking those who were condemned. Now fast forward to 29 years after the tattoo gun was invented, it's already become a little more common. American circuses started hiring people with full body tattoos for their shows and would allow them to make around $200 a week. And this is what one of the circus members would look like, fully tattooed. After another 50 years had passed, tattoos started to become a mark of sailors and veterans. Just like art, tattoos are criticized. With enough exposure, it could gain a following. So earlier on, tattoos were banned for a short time due to a hepatitis B scare. Hepatitis B was an issue because it is spread by being exposed to infected body fluids, so that kind of rules out tattoos as you can't bleed when you get one. However, to combat this, there came the temporary tattoo. Soon, tattoos were in children's toys, as you can see here. In 1991, the butterfly art Barbie, a doll with washable body art, was created. And you can see around her midriff area, there's like a little sticker that you can take and put on and then take off. With all of that information, you now have the history of tattoos tattooed in your mind. All right. We started with the tattoo gun of the speech, that being the history of the tattoo gun. Next, we had the needle, which represented the history behind tattoos. And then lastly, we ended with the tattooing process, of which showed the relationship between tattoos and society. Although tattoos are widely accepted in today's society, still be careful with what you get, because you don't want to be that person who thinks they have an amazing tattoo, when in reality it is misspelled and it says something along the lines of no regrets. And there are some bad tattoos for you. Thank you.